Oh, good morning, everybody, and welcome to another Facebook Live on this Thursday morning, 22nd of March, 8:15. Tim McNiff joining you once again from McNiff's Riffs. And in this new life that I have here, I get to write about really whatever I want to write about. So this isn't really a sports thing. It's definitely not a sports thing. It's really not a news opinion thing at all. It's sort of just a peek behind the curtain at sort of thing that happens, I guess, to everybody, I hope, every day, because it definitely happened to me the other night. And not my best moment, not my proudest moment. I never claimed to be the sharpest knife in the drawer, and I think you get full evidence of that. And I just giving you a little peek behind the personal life. And I got to tell you, for many years when I was doing this and my kids were growing up, I was bound to determine that they were never going to be a prop. I was never going to use them, you know, as a way of garnering favor or ratings or anything like that. And so it's kind of been just in recent times that I even asked them, is it okay if I write about this and talk about this? And when I asked about this, my I have two daughters, the older of which is back living at home with us, which is common among people. She graduated in the spring and is saving money to where she can go back to where she wants to do and try to forge her career. The other one is studying abroad at the moment. So the one that's home wanted it to be known that she was in no way, shape, or form responsible for any of the events of that day. So there is her putting that out there in her defense. Good morning, Brandy. Gina said, good night, great shirt. I got to tell you, I wish I could take responsibility for it. I really can't. For most of my clothes, they're bought for me. And the three people that I just mentioned are responsible for that. Christine, thank you very much. I miss you guys too, but hopefully through these interactions and the things that I'm doing, we get to keep a relationship and a conversation going, and I hope you'll check me out on these other formats. Good morning, Mike. Good morning, Susan. Good morning, Karen. Cindy, miss seeing you every morning too, but you, who knows? Who knows what'll happen in the future? This may be one of those formats that allows us to interact on a lot more frequent basis. Teresa, good morning from Dairyland, Wisconsin. I hope things are going well for you there.
By my cabin, Tim.
Oh, Dana Thede, who's helping me out, just pointing out that that's by his cabin. So if you hear things coming from near a lake, what lake would that be, Dana?
That would be Leader Lake.
Leader Lake. Just don't ask any questions.
By Gordon.
Yes. Yeah, don't ask any questions. Laura, nice. I miss you, too. Michonne, good to see your name and face out there. Heather, good morning. Nancy, good morning. Hi from Cottage Grove, Minnesota. Heidi, cool glasses, necessary glasses. I just haven't gone in and got the LASIK or anything done yet, so I got to have the cheaters. Mark says, what's the good word? The good word is I am not a smart man. And that's what I wrote a piece about, and that's on the Care 11 Facebook page. Did you change the title? Because the original title I had was, Finding the Funk. I like it. Yeah, currently I had at least we didn't blow up the house, or at least the house didn't blow up. We just had a situation the other day where we had a funky smell coming from our house, could not determine the source of it, became convinced that it was a natural gas leak, or concerned at least that it was a natural gas leak, and then did everything wrong. By the time we even went through the list of all the things, they say not to do in case you think you have a natural gas leak. I mean, we're not cigarette smokers, but that was the only thing we hadn't done by that point. So, right. Linda saying drink soon, like for me today, or are you talking about getting together? No, I would love to get together with you and John. That would be great. Be good to see you if you're indeed back from Florida and the Magic Kingdom. Deb, good morning. And Deb Shipman Jacobson says good morning to you. Danish.
Deb.
Yeah. Nita Larson, I miss you too. Thank you very much. Nick, thank you. Amy Sorensen says, go Delano boys basketball. Good luck in the tournament. That's great. Marie, good morning to St. Louis Park. Darlene, you have a great day. Maggie, thank you. Good morning to you. Randy, good morning to you. Julie, so I think I'm caught up on that end. Working back down again. Good morning from Staples, says Connie Martinez. Great wrestling in Staples. Good morning from Kyle, Texas. Amy Lee, originally from St. Paul. Kyle, that's down around College Station in Texas A&M, I believe. Good morning to you. Nice to have you along. You know, I'm going to be joined in a couple minutes by one of the new people that's joined the staff here at Care 11, a wonderful young woman by the name of Marissa Candido, unless she's had a change of heart. And Marissa's got some great ideas for things that we're going to do with this space going forward. So hopefully we'll be producing some interesting content. You know, Monday I wrote a piece, talked about the local teams in win now mode, and talked about how that could be bad news for Don Lucia. And 24 hours later, Don indeed did step down as Gopher hockey coach on his own terms, where he gets to stay for another year as sort of an advisor to the University of Minnesota and their program. I'm going to write a piece on Sunday profiling the candidates for that job. I've got some interesting takes on some of the candidates and the perspective on the job itself from somebody who works in that profession. So something I'm working on for next Sunday. Roberta, man, you've been there forever. It's good to see you, and always good to hear you as well. This is special. I got a message here from Penny, Pam Penny Simons, widow of Rod Simons. And I said, Rod was a huge fan of yours. Well, you know what? As you know, Pam, I was a huge fan of his too, and loved the times that I was able to be on the radio program with him, and enjoyed working with Rod quite a bit. And sorry for your loss. Emily, good morning from Redwood Falls. It says, I'm new today. Like, new to this world? New to this conversation? Well, glad to have you here, and hope you'll come back. And newcomers, sure, great. Cheryl, I'm not coming back to Sunrise that I'm aware of, but I'm here and doing this, and I'm writing these pieces and engaging with people on different formats, and really hope that you'll check out these things that I'm writing, and usually sports related, but they've given me the freedom to write about whatever I want to. So hopefully you check out the column, hopefully you find some humor in it, you recognize some things from a relationship standpoint in it, and love to hear your feedback. And if you hate it, tell me that too, and I'll never do it again.
Tim, every Monday.
Yep, every Monday.
And intermittently, right?
Yeah, you know, every Monday, the kind of the schedule is that every Monday I'm going to produce a piece of content for the Care 11 Facebook page and for the home, the care11.com. And it's sort of, you know, insider sports, and so it'll be sort of, it can be opinion, and I'm going to talk to people, and, you know, people we may have lost track of, catch up with some people and give you an update on where they are and what they're doing and how their perspective may relate to something that's going on right now. And at the same time, look at sports issues as they're happening and kind of give you some inside information on that. So that'll be Monday, so you can look for one of these from me generally on Monday mornings at about the same time, about 8:10, 8:15 a.m. And then again Thursday, maybe Friday later in the week, another one of these as it kind of goes along. So that's kind of the schedule as I know it. Patty, you rock. Thank you very much. Kelly, good morning to Elk River. Randy, peace and love, my friend. Healing slowly. What happened to you, Randy? Let me know what's going on with you, my friend. Brett, nice to be back, my friend. Good to hear from you. Gene saying hello from Chile, Florida. Are you being a wise guy, or are you having a little cold snap down there? Good morning from Hammond, Wisconsin, says Karen. Good to see you, Sandy. Good to see you from Blue Earth. Mark asks, did you get your Foo tickets? I haven't got my Foo Fighter tickets yet. I'm very aware that they are coming, and I probably should have done that. I'm going to go see Jack White in August, so looking forward to a little bit of that, the White Stripes. But looking forward to the Foo Fighters coming back as well.
New album. Well, have you heard his new album?
I have not. I have not. I have not or seen a review on it either. How are you ready with that?
Got lucky, man.
Dana Thede, just throwing it out there. And something else, you guys, I want to point out that I do at the end of these, when I write these things at the end of it, I'm always going to put something on the very end, which is either going to be a quote that I like, or a song recommendation, or a movie recommendation, something that I've seen, something along those lines, something to give you a little bonus at the very end. And I did put a quote on there this morning, basically just something about how, you know, life gives you things, and it's about how you react to it. Is that what we've got there? I'd be kidding you if I said I could read that.
Life is 10% what happens to you,
and 90% how you react. Yeah, but there you go, Charles R. Soule. So there you go. So yeah, I just want to always give you guys something on the end of it. You know, just something. Last week we did with the start of the NCAA basketball tournament or free agency. We did top 11 songs with the word free in the title. So I'm going to just do some of those things as the mood strikes me too, or as I'm prompted by my friend and colleague here, Dana Thede, to do these things. Got a bunch of people checking in. Tony, nice to have you here. Julia, good morning from Le Sueur. Glad to be back and keep this association with Care 11. Thank you. Shayna, good morning down in Florida. Kim, nice to have you. Michonne, she's going to see Tim McGraw in Faith Hill. Tim McGraw took a collapsed recently on stage, so I hope that he's okay. Nancy checking in from Austin, Texas. Hope things are returning to normal back down there. You had a scare. Tammy from Otsego. Amy watching. Shanna. Georgia says it's chilly there, too, in the 30s. Peggy checking in from Esterville, Iowa. Says the Winchester's movie you should see. Kim says that, the Winchester movie. Not familiar with it. I'll check it out. Andy and Paul, good morning to you. And Dana, our friend Diana Pierce, checking in this morning. Yeah, good to hear from you and hope this finds you well. You still owe me the money, but that's okay. I won't bring it up right now. It'll be our little secret. LaDonna from Centuria, nice to have you. Another name we used to engage quite a bit in these Facebook Lives when we were doing the mornings. Jill, good morning from Dassel. Patricia from Ramsey and Terry from Delano. Now, I'm thinking, Dana Thede, that my friend and co-worker, Marissa Candido, has stood me up. So maybe she got a better offer. Yeah, she's sitting around chatting with the Sunrise crew. So I don't know how much...
She actually is coming, Tim.
We had to give her the hook and reel her in. I want her to jump in here quick, introduce herself. Be careful walking across here now.
Hey, don't fall.
I don't know if you can go the whole problem of hooking that up, because we've just got a couple minutes left.
I'll just clip it on here.
Can you scoot over towards me a little bit without it being creepy? Probably not, but do it anyway. There she is.
Nice close. This is a meeting, Tim. Don't
All right. Well, welcome.
Thanks, Tim.
And how long have you been here at CARE?
I've been here for 2 months, so I'm pretty new, fresh to the scene.
And?
I love it.
So far, so good.
Yeah, and I love the Twin Cities.
It's my desk partner. Yes. We sit next to each other. And
yeah, so we're used to sitting this close together, right next to each other.
Not quite, but yeah. But, she's seen some of the things that I like to do, and we love to talk music and movies and a lot of similarities. And so you've got some ideas for things we might be able to do.
Yeah, so I'm thinking that we might be able to up this digital segment you have going on a little bit and add some new fun things in there. I love Tim's interviewing style and when he talks to people, all the things you manage to get out of people. So I think we can
usually
really...
it's confessions. But...
that's a huge strength. So I'm excited that we're going to be doing some more of those in-depth interviews, and then hopefully doing some fun social things along with that that will help you get to know some of the interview subjects a little better outside of, you know, whatever sport or political sphere, whatever they happen to be doing. So
or hanging out in the driveway.
Yeah, or hanging out in the driveway with the McNiff's.
Yeah, well, we posted a video of my daughter from inside the van when we were waiting to see if the house was going to blow up or not, waiting for our emergency responder. I shouldn't use that term, I guess, because he was from
that was Amy back then.
Energy company. Yeah.
Tim, I'm disappointed in you that you wanted to leave the cat behind. As a cat person,
it was my wife's call.
I don't believe that for a second.
Really wasn't. I just didn't think it was going to happen. I'm like, the cat's not an outside cat. I made a call. Mm-hmm. It was the wrong call. I freely admit.
I made the wrong call. I hope you're getting some comments on here from my fellow cat lovers.
Yeah. So Marissa, you do social media for the Morning Sunrise.
Yep.
And so she's got a great skill set and a lot of things that I don't know and I'm eager to learn. So we want to work together on some projects, something you brought up, and I'm very thankful for that and look forward to that. And you'll probably regret it in a short period of time, but
I don't think
we'll go
Tim.
From there. Before we check out of here, I want to say Jill, good morning. I checked in from Dassel, Patricia from Ramsey, Terry from Delano, Carol, Jimmy, had some surgery watching you. You had surgery watching us. Well, someone say it's like surgery watching us, so good luck with that. I hope that goes well.
I like Cats Lives Matter, they do. Thank you, LaDonna. Cats yeah. lives matter.
I like the cat. Dexter and I do well together for the most part. Yeah. So no, it was, yeah. So check out the article, check out the other content. I've got another piece that'll air on Monday morning. And in the meantime, we're going to get our heads together and we're going to work on some projects going forward. We call it McNiff's Riffs, but boy, you can riff on anything that that I got going here.
Oh,
so
yeah.
Thank you for stopping by. And thank you for stopping by. And again, next Monday morning, we'll do another one of these Facebook Lives. And love to have you guys stop in and check out what we're doing. Please, again, check out the article, Care 11 Facebook page, and on care11.com. And I'll put it on my links on my Facebook and Twitter accounts as well. Have a great day, everybody. We thank you for your time and your attention. Have a great weekend. And we'll look forward to seeing you back here next Monday.
Bye.
See ya.
Super guest star.
Okay.
Super guest star. You never know who's going to drop by, you know?
No.
Just check it out. You never know who's going to.